Good day, folks. I'm in the Scottish borders today, the Royal Borough of Jedburgh. I'm going to show you around the Jedburgh Castle Jail Museum. We'll take it right from now. Jedburgh Castle. On this site, from the 12th century, stood a major royal castle founded by King David I. Scots and English armies fought over it constantly. In 1409, Albany, Regent of Scotland, ordered its demolition so that the English could not hold it. In 1823, a Howard Reform prison was built on the site. So that's Jedburgh Castle. Townhead Port. Near here was the Townhead Port or Gate. Ports were a key feature of medieval towns, which helped defend the borough in times of danger. Jedburgh had four ports which controlled the flow of people and goods in and out of the royal borough. Jedburgh Castle Jail and Museum is built on the site of Jedburgh's medieval castle, which was destroyed in 1409. In 1823, a new prison was built for the royal borough of Jedburgh. It was designed by Scottish architect Archibald Elliot. The jailer's house now contains a museum of local history with displays about the history of the prison located in the adjacent cell blocks. Between the cell blocks are exercise yards surrounded by a high crenellated wall. The castle jail is an important example of early 19th century architecture. Well, we're at the start of the Jedburgh Castle Jail Museum tour, folks, and we're going to front entrance right now. This is Jedburgh Castle grounds we're in. So, entering Jail's House and Town Museum. Going in there. Now again, folks, I'll do exactly the same as what I not always do. I'll run through the scripts. And you can either pause or you can press the right hand bottom of your computer and that will enlarge your screen. It'll give you a full screen and you can learn at ease. You can read at ease then, you see? Okay, so here we go. It's about the early history. From Roman Britain onwards. Victorian jailer. Records show that there were at least 8 different jailers employed at Jedburgh Castle Jail. They're all locked up there. It must be very cold in that jail. Roman soldier and Silgovi warrior. The Romans were in the borders for over 300 years. The local Silgovi people were defeated and controlled by the Romans. And that's them there. It's a Roman centurion there with his prisoner, the Silgovi man. Jailer's house. Jedburgh Jailer lived in this building in a 2-room flat with his family. Welcome to Jedburgh Castle Jail and Museum. That's it there.
this is the Aberdeen. Some artifacts there. It's a view of Jedburgh Abbey from the southwest, 1793. The Cape on Tree. Presented by Miss Agnes P. O'Brien. Castle room. This is the Abbey Friary here. Archaeologists there working. Charter of Jedburgh, it's very small print there, so you will have to enlarge your screen. Various domestic carving and hanging utensils. The castle. And David the First's charter granted Jedburgh to the monks, he distinguishes the town by the castle. Jedburgh measure. The fragile piece. Battle of Bannockburn, yeah. Are you fit for prison? Says here. Are you fit for prison? Jedburgh Castle Jail Prison Record. Some of the clothing that he used to wear. Jedburgh's here. Mediaeval bullet. Jedburgh axes. No, that's how they dressed up in those days. I think it's always the Queen Mary of Scots. Queen Mary of Scots there. Bothwell, Earl of Bothwell. I think that is supposed to be Queen Mary of Scots. Okay, we continue the tour to the cell block. We're going to the cell block now, folks. Welcome to the Bridal House of Correction. Business. Bridal. These are the cells. They're the original cells. You see all the doors? Little peephole there that the prison guard would look through just to make sure they were all right. Make sure they wouldn't get up to mischief. More safe. The would-be body snatchers. Iron box placed over a coffin to deter would-be body snatchers. And it's in there. You know what a body snatching ground in those days was the medical profession. Operation of Bridewell. Vagrants, this one. Vagrants. This is another deal, so the plight of prisoners was largely a matter of indifference to the public. This is by courtesy of the National Portrait Gallery, London. Another cell, Archibald Elliot. Mm-hmm. Third trespass. This prison here. For thefts and trespassers. Thieves and trespassers. Many boys who from its trifling value will take a turnip, but would not steal anything else. Hard labour. Treatment of the insane. A bit dark here, folks. Children suffered the same punishment as the adults. Looks in dire straits, this fella. He's in trouble. Yes. Guard bed, he says here. For reoffending prisoners. Robert Black. That's who it is. Hard labour. By 1880, Jedburgh Castle failed to meet the established building standards of the time. What was that? Continue your tour of Jedburgh Castle Jail Museum. Bells. Jedburgh Castle. Private Thomas Thurmel, that's who that was. That's in there. Changing off the face of Jedburgh. Alexander Jeffrey. The Economy of Jedburgh, 1750-1799. Trade Minister Jedburgh. Town Plan of Jedburgh, 1750-1815. Sir Walter Scott. Lanterns. George Ritchie, the Reverend George Ritchie, that's in there. Science and Learning, Jedburgh Science and Learning. Bristol. Bristol's intentions. It's all the artifacts there for Bristol's. James Veitch. Exploring the skies. Some there. John Easley. mediaeval maps. Artist impression of John Ainslie using a sextant. Mary Somerville, Queen of Science, 1780 to 1872. That's up there, Mary Somerville. James Hutton, discovering deep time. What's up there? Having our dinner. Male prisoners. Punishment in the 1970s, anyway. Because they can read it later, you see. Early Law and Order in Jedburgh. Debtors' room. Robert Middles. And that's us.
So that's us, folks. Signing out now. Hope you've enjoyed the visit to Jedburgh Castle and Museum here in the Royal Borough of Jedburgh. Hope to see you all on the next journey. TCSS, take care, stay safe. Bye for now.